We gather together on this, the second Sunday in ordinary time, and we greet God as always, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
We gather to remember that we are called by God to be disciples and evangelists. God, help us to listen for your voice. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
God, help us to respond well when we are called to pray. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
God, at times we are reluctant to acknowledge you. Help us this week to say yes to your invitation. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us all to life everlasting.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. God, you govern all things in heaven and on earth. Hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Samuel. Samuel was sleeping in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was. The Lord called to Samuel, who answered, "Here I am." Samuel ran to Eli and said, "Here I am. You called me." "I did not call you," Eli said. "Go back to sleep." So he went back to sleep. Again, the Lord called Samuel, who rose and went to Eli. "Here I am," he said. "You called me." But Eli answered, "I did not call you, my son. Go back to sleep." At that time, Samuel was not familiar with the Lord, because the Lord had not revealed anything to him as yet. The Lord called Samuel again for the third time. Getting up and going to Eli, he said, "Here I am. You called me." Then Eli understood that the Lord was calling the youth. So he said to Samuel, "Go to sleep, and if you are called, reply, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" When Samuel went to sleep in his place, the Lord came and revealed his presence, calling out as before, "Samuel, Samuel." Samuel answered, "Speak, for your servant is listening." Samuel grew up, and the Lord was with him, not permitting any word of his to be without effect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the body is not for immorality, but for the Lord. And the Lord is for the body. God raised the Lord and will also raise us by his power. Do you not know that your bodies are members of Christ? But whoever is joined to the Lord becomes one spirit with him. Avoid immorality. Every other sin a person commits is outside the body. But the immoral person sins against his own body. Do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, whom you have from God, and that you are not your own? For you have been purchased at a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Lord, be on my thoughts. Lord, be on my lips. Lord, live in my heart. John was standing with two of his disciples, and as he watched Jesus walk by, he said, "Behold, the Lamb of God." The two disciples heard what he said and followed Jesus. Jesus turned and saw them following him and said to them, "What are you looking for?" They said to him, "Rabbi," which means teacher. "Where are you staying?" Jesus said to them, "Come, and you will see." So they went and saw where Jesus was staying, and they stayed with him that day. It was about 4 in the afternoon. Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, was one of the two who heard John and followed Jesus. He first found his own brother, Simon, and told him, "We have found the Messiah," which is translated Christ. Then he brought him to Jesus. Jesus looked at him and said, You are Simon, son of John. You will be called Cephas, which is translated Peter. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
A word of welcome to all our guests and visitors that stopped in to be with us and praise God. Just two announcements. Please check our bulletin, our website, social media for all the different opportunities for virtual and in-person possibilities here at Holy Family. One upcoming offering is called Coping with Chaos, Finding Peace of Mind and Soul, a virtual seminar which will be a conversation to share ways to deal with these difficult times. See the website and bulletin for registration details. Reluctant disciples and evangelists. We find them throughout the scriptures. People are drawn in. An invitation is given. But people say, "Who, me?" Moses with the burning bush, "Come no closer, take off your shoes. I got a job for you." His response was, "Who, me?" Jeremiah, another reluctant prophet, "I am too young, and you have duped me, but I will go." Reluctant disciples and evangelists. Even Mary paused and said, "How can this be?" Joseph had many dreams. The angels had to keep coming at him. And so too with us, in terms of how do we respond to God's invitation to be his disciple, follower, his evangelist. Let's just start by saying it's never easy to follow the Lord. Let's just get that out there. But God does not give us an invitation without giving us the foundation to say, "Oh, okay, I'll try it." Down through the centuries, through different generations, there's always been folks who had a message to share with the larger crowd. On this weekend, we're mindful of the most recent Martin Luther King. It continues. The question I have for all of us at this time is, how did you and I respond to the invitation? Some invitations are easy to take. Others are you kidding me? All of us were called by God to make a choice on January 6th in terms of, holy moly. Some of us responded with, "Where is God?" Others responded with, "Go get him." Still others, "Help me to pray, God. Help me to pray." It's never easy. But the call keeps coming out to us. "You are my children, with whom I am well pleased." Faith is caught, not so much taught. A prayer I found very helpful these past several days has to do with understanding faith as a disciple and an evangelist. Faith doesn't always take you out of the problem. Faith takes you through the problem. Faith doesn't always take away the pain. Faith gives you the ability to handle the pain. Faith doesn't always take you out of the storm. Faith calms you down in the midst of the storm. We are reluctant disciples and evangelists, but God does not give up on us. He continues to guide us, hold us, and strengthen us to be witness, to give testimony, even if it's a simple prayer. Oh God, let your angels and saints be present in the midst of the chaos. We can do something in response to the invitation. Here I am, Lord, here I am. I come to do your will. Hold me close. Help me get through it with your grace. Let your light shine. Amen.
Amen.
We stand and pray. Our creed, together we pray. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried.
And rose again
on the third day,
in accordance
with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. Come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sin, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead
and the life of the world to come. Amen.
We come before the Lord with our prayers and our petitions.
Our response is, gracious Lord, hear our prayer. For people everywhere across our nation who are anxious and fearful, may we learn to attentively listen to the voices of the angry and the disappointed, creating conversations that are rational and safe, so that solutions for the common good might take root. We pray to the Lord.
Gracious Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of governments, leaders of communities, leaders of churches, may they serve their people by ensuring fairness and justice for all through honest dialogue and right judgment. We pray to the Lord.
Gracious Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer or are in pain, we especially lift up our families or friends who are ill, especially those suffering from the coronavirus. May abundant vaccines be given, and may all who are sick find healing. We pray to the Lord.
Gracious Lord, hear our prayer.
For the worries and concerns we hold in the silence of our hearts right now, we pray to the Lord.
Gracious Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are joining our church through the RCIA. We pray, too, for those preparing for sacraments in our parish, especially for those preparing for First Eucharist and for Confirmation. May they experience Christ's love more and more each day as they continue their faith journey. We pray to the Lord.
Gracious Lord, hear our prayer.
For those discerning their vocation and the many and varied ministries of the church and workplace, may their hearts and minds be open to the generous possibilities shown them by the Holy Spirit, as did those Jesus called in the gospel today. We pray to the Lord.
Gracious Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who call us to justice in our daily living, as we celebrate the Dr. Martin Luther King holiday, may God's justice continue to guide our efforts in embracing all people in the workplace, in our neighborhoods, and in our churches. We pray to the Lord.
Gracious Lord, hear our prayer.
God, thank you for your arms that wrap around us and hold us. Thank you for lifting us when we fall. Hear our prayer. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Because of your time, talent, and treasure, the ministries of Holy Family are able to go beyond these walls to help others in need. Thank you so much. Thank you. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our benefit of all of his holy church.
Grant to us, O God, a heart renewed. Recreate in us your own spirit, Lord. Grant that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things. Jesus Christ, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer. Incarnate by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, Jesus stretched out his arms as he endured his passion upon that cross to break the bonds of death and make known the resurrection. And so we join the angels and saints in song. God, you are holy. Let your Spirit come upon these gifts to make them holy, that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, Jesus took bread and gave you thanks, Father, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice. Again, he gave you praise and thanks, Father. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Thank you.
We celebrate the memorial of his passion, death, and resurrection. And we offer you, God, our Father, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and serve you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by your Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church gathered here at Holy Family and all over your world. Help us to grow in charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, James, our Bishop, all the clergy and all your people. God, our Father, remember our brothers and sisters who have died. All who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, welcome them home into the light of your presence. And thank you, God, for having mercy on us. And we pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her spouse, the apostles and saints, we too may merit eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Together we stand and we pray that prayer that Jesus taught us. Whose Father? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Grant us peace in our day. Keep us free from sin and protect us from daily anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Ask God to bless that saint on your left. Ask God to bless that saint on your right. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Thank you.
As I lift high the body and blood of Jesus Christ, I invite all of us to look upon Jesus, believe in his real presence, invite him into our hearts. Pray this prayer as if it were the last prayer of our lives. Behold the Lamb of God, behold Jesus, who takes away the sin of the world and heals us. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
What are you thankful for? How is God blessing you? Close your eyes for just a quick second. See yourself walking with God. Turn to God and simply say, God, I want to thank you for. Take a quiet moment. Amen.
Amen.
Please stand and let us pray. God, pour out the spirit of your love upon us, and in your kindness, make us to be nourished by your body, this heavenly food, and be of one mind and one heart with Christ. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
And God does bless us. Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass continues. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.